Hi, my name is Erika Reineke, and this is Liza Toppa. We're here at Lauderdale Yacht Club, and this week we're going to be putting out some footage on the double-handed sailing in the 420. Recently, we've put out a lot of information on the opti and video on the laser stuff, but we feel that the double-handed is also very important, especially for high school sailing, and will give you guys a head start when you go into college sailing. In high school and college sailing, it's really important to go over your boat before you start the racing because during or between each set, you're rotating and switching boats constantly. So it's important to make sure that you're going over the lines, the tension in the rig, adjusting the hiking strap, and just really making sure that you're setting up the boat for how you like it. And a lot of the times too, like when you're switching boats, lines can become loose or the previous skipper and crew have something set differently that you're not used to. So it's really important to go over the whole boat from bow to stern and make sure that everything's set for how you like. In high school and college sailing, the pins are preset for the event, so you're not allowed to adjust them. So that makes tension in the jib really important. So basically what I like to do in order to like make tension markings or settings, if you will, is I put a piece of tape right up here, electrical tape, and because you won't always have these lines here. So you put a piece of tape here, and I tell my crew to put on max tension, and we get the tension strapped just so we know where the max is, and we make the tape mark right there. And that way, when we ease off tension, we know exactly how much we're easing off, and if we pull it back on, we know where max tension is at. If tension ever becomes too hard to pull on, the skipper can turn downwind, and that'll help the crew pull on a little bit more tension with the mast leaning forward. If it's still a little hard to pull on, the crew can ask the skipper to help also pull on the line. Having the tension set properly is really important for speed in the 420 and in the FJ. So the best way to gauge the tension and like when the boat is set up correctly is actually by the feel in the helm. And if the tension is too loose, then there's gonna be really wide groove. And if it's too tight, the groove in the helm is gonna be a little too hard to steer to because it's so narrow. As the wind starts to increase and we get into those max power conditions, that's usually the best time to have max tension. And when I know that tension is set correctly and like the max tension feels good is when both me and my crew are hiking full out and we're able to control the boat. When the tension is max and I feel like the boat is too powered up and my crew and I aren't able to hold the boat down properly with hiking and main sheet trim, that's when I know I need to back off on the tension and get the boat a little bit more under control, especially when the wind starts to increase in the high teens or in the 20s. In the double-handed boat, communication is really important. You have two people in the boat and you need to make sure that you're both on the same page, so it's different from the opti and the laser. Today, we have Liza Toppa, who is a multi-collegiate national champion, to go over communication.
Thanks, Erika. So what she said was super important. Now I'm gonna be going over communication from a crew's perspective. So one of the most important jobs as a crew is keeping the skipper aware and in the moment, whether you have a bad start, a bad tack, a bad mark rounding, you're always giving them the next piece of information to keep their head in the game and stay positive. So before every race, my skipper and I always go upwind, do a couple tacks, we check the line, check the course, do accelerations. We always come up with a game plan and that gets us focused and ready for the race. During the sequence, it's my responsibility as a crew to give my skipper information about boats around us, the time, and what's going on up the race course. So once we have a spot on the line with about a minute to go, I'm relaying the time to my skipper. I'm looking upwind for anything going on up the course. I'm keeping us aware of the boats around us. I'm listening to my skipper for jib trim and body placement, all the while I'm giving my skipper positive reinforcement. Under 10 seconds, I'm counting down every second and I'm cueing off my skipper's movements to properly synchronize us for a fast acceleration.
So we've got a storm coming, so we're gonna wrap this episode up, but make sure to subscribe
and comment down below.